Hey everybody, it's me, Christopher Travels. I am hot and thirsty. Anyway, here's the detailed tour. Well, as detailed as I possibly can be. I have a lot of videos from when I started building Frankie, but I did make a lot of upgrades to make Frankie lighter, so I'm gonna go through just a few little things on it, so stay tuned. First, I'm gonna show you, here's my little college, like, dorm refrigerator. And it has plenty of room, and it runs perfectly on my solar. Let's see. Here's some of the boxes that go in the dresser inside, which I'll show you in just a little bit. There's one of my new rims and tire. My hot water heater, instant hot water heater. Okay, so we are outside. So there's Frankie. So first, I replaced the 2x4s that were on the side with this polycarbonate stuff. And before I forget, this is the power inlet I put on the outside there. And I replaced the lap siding that was very heavy with this polycarbonate. And I have my storage box there, which I have like some bungee cords and wires and stuff for now. My propane tank. And this is my inlet, my water inlet to fill my tank. I think I have a 13 gallon tank, I'm not really sure, but it's like 10 or 13. And this is if you want to hook directly to a hose. And then this I put so I can run my instant hot water heater line outside. And when I'm docking, I'll hang it right here and lock it, of course. And I have my propane tank there. And Deborah Joy gave me these stickers for my window. She did sign it, Deborah Joy, but it's faded since. This is my pipe from my sink, my kitchen sink. And here's the back with my Dutch door. A channel here, Ramblin' Rogers. His wife made that for me. So awesome. At the last RTR, I got that. That is to attach my Wi-Fi antenna. It's a really tall Wi-Fi antenna. It reaches about 3 miles away. And right here is going to be my running light. For some odd reason, I can't figure out how to make the harness inside the car make the trailer lights do running and stop. So I made the car do the stop. So these will stay off until I press on the brake, and then they'll shine really bright because they are LEDs. So this, when I travel, I'll wire from this. I'll just pull these wires and hook them into my... Oops, hold on, let me turn off the radio.
For more information or to schedule a complimentary network...
There we go. So I'll hook it right in there before I start driving. That way it'll be on. So you look inside here, and I've got plenty of room. I have a 200 amp hour battery there and a 200 amp hour battery there. And I made these covers so nothing fell on top of them. So I don't think we should sit on them, but you know, it's just gonna be what it is. And I made this cover here to cover those wires. I have a 3000 watt pure sine wave inverter and a 200 amp breaker right there. So the panel comes in on the roof here. It's a 280 watt panel, and it comes in here, and it goes into my 30 amp tracer charge controller, and I have the panel switch off, so I can switch this off if I don't want to charge my batteries, and then also the remote. So, the power inlet goes to this outlet, and also that outlet. So right now, what I have hooked up to my positive box, my fuse box, is my water pump. And then just this 12 volt into USB. So when you walk in, I have this dresser, and I'll have all these boxes inside. Oh, and I hung some. This is just like a piece of where you hang your shoes. That's the same as that. It's the same thing. Let's see. I guess I'll go over here and show you my water, my sink. So what I do is, I'm going to have a switch for my water pump. But for now, all I do is, I just plug it in. And my water pump is over there, and the water goes through these pipes going along here, and it goes along the bottom and up through here. And so when you turn it on, so it automatically turns off. So then when I'm done, I don't want to build up too much pressure. I just pull the fuse, and then I just let out. The water. Ooh, yay! Up here is my little rack. My catch-all rack, I guess. Down here is like a pantry area. I'll have the same type of boxes that holds my dry goods through there, and then I'll just use this for paper towels and stuff like that. Here's my gas stove, which I'll cook with it. right there. And then when I'm done, I'll just put it away. There you go. And this is probably going to be for cleaning supplies and stuff like that. I have my TV mount. I don't watch very much TV, but I think it would be nice to have one just in case I want to watch DVDs or something. Oh yeah. Those who are new to the channel, this is canvas, and it can roll up and stick to here, and then the top can be put down. It's just on these gas struts, like that, and then it just pops right back up. So when I roll them down, I hold them with these long magnets that usually stick knives and stuff to. And up front here, I made it so it has a screen, and also this comes down and makes it waterproof, like that. But it's a little hot, so I have it open. There you go. Let's see, my mason jars. And that's my shower curtain. And if you haven't seen my video, up on the roof, I have this wire. And I tied it around the bolts there, going all the way in a square. I don't know, I put one there, but it seemed too tight, so I extended it one. So I just hooked my shower curtain to this, and then the shower curtain goes down into a bin. Actually, my bin is back there, and the bin will have this, and then I'll put this and the bin through the hole right there. And that drains all the way through. And you know, if I take a shower, if it's not okay to drain water onto the grounds, then I can put a bucket underneath. It's not a problem. And there's my tank back there. I think that's a 10-gallon or a 13-gallon tank. I'm proud of doing that. And this is where my fridge is gonna go. It's gonna sit right there. This is you've seen my compost toilet. So for the most part, I'd probably end up putting it right there. And I have plenty of space to walk. The walls are cedar, very light weight cedar siding. Here's another. I'll probably put my little buddy heater in there to secure it. I guess that is it. I'm trying to think. I guess that's it. So, I hope you liked the walk around. It gives you inspiration to possibly make something yourself, or, you know, just some ideas. But I am going to be at the RTR the whole time, and if you'd like to come and see me or see Frankie or whatever, come on over. Just message me. I'm sure I'll do a video by then. Or maybe a video that I'm there, and then you can comment and say, "Where are you?" So I know they're changing spots this year, and they said it's going to be a lot better. So anyway, so that's Frankie in a nutshell. So thanks for watching. Live life to the fullest. I'll see you next time. Bye.